Hi, I'm John Miller, the Deliberate Engineer. So today I'm going to take a shot at solving a LeetCode problem. This particular problem is one that was asked for. It's the TwoSum problem. It's listed as an easy problem. It is relatively straightforward as long as you do all the right things solving it. So some questions you might have. Is it a good interview problem? Yeah, this is one I'd feel okay asking in an interview as a sort of warm-up problem. The things that make it a good problem is it has multiple solutions of different complexities. You can put together the simplest solution relatively quickly, as we'll show today, and then you can work on making it more efficient. If the candidate is going down the wrong path, you can correct them at any time, and with just a couple of hints, really get them back on the right path. So overall, it's a good problem that somebody would ask in an interview. Now, having said that, this is my third attempt at solving this problem. The first time I tried to solve it, I got ahead of myself and I made two mistakes when I was reading the problem. The first mistake was that I thought it was saying I couldn't create an order n squared solution, which is the easy solution, which in fact you are allowed to. The second one has to do with solving the problem. So the problem in a nutshell is you have an input array of integers, not sorted or anything, and there can be duplicates in the array, and you have a value that you're trying to add up two items from the array and have them equal that value. According to the problem statement, there's only a single solution to this. And the input array is relatively short, so that means it's going to be a nice bounded problem. But the duplicates can cause problems, and figuring out how to solve it and returning the right thing can cause a problem. The return value, so there's guaranteed to be exactly one solution. The return value is supposed to be the indices in the input array of what the two elements are that add up to be the target value. The mistake I made was I sorted that array and then I returned the indices of that sorted array, which of course didn't work because the indices were different. Even though I was able to find the solution, I described it wrong. My third attempt actually went quite well and I put everything together, but the tools that I was using to record it, I didn't configure them quite right. I'm still learning how to do this, and so again, we miss it. So this is I guess that was my second attempt. This is my third attempt. It's going to go great. You're going to love it. We're all going to love it. Hopefully you can read the screen this time. We'll find out as we go. Anyway, so the first thing I do when I'm trying to solve a LeetCode problem is I'll take a look at it. I don't pay so much attention to the description of it, but I'll look and make sure, first of all, it's assuming there's exactly one solution. That means we don't have to do error checking or look for really weird cases. That's great. The answer can be returned in any order, and the answer is the indices of two numbers. And we can see in Java that winds up being an integer array that I'll create that will have the two indices in. Okay, so I know I need to create an integer array and return it. I know I have a set of numbers that are the input, and then I'll actually go and take a look down at the constraints. Okay, so the array of inputs can be up to 10,000 long. Oh, that's actually pretty good. And it's going to be at least two items, which makes sense since there has to be a solution. The numbers look like they're in the normal 32-bit range for integers, more or less. And there's only one valid answer. Well, that's great. You know, all that's good. And then another good thing you can do is take a look at the input examples. Like, let's take a look at this one. It's got duplicate numbers. Well, they said never said it wasn't allowed. But you're not allowed to use the same number twice, in other words, the same position in the input array. So what we do instead is we take these two inputs, and this would give the indexes 0, 1. Okay, yeah, you know, I think I have the solution to it. So you're going to see me solve this quicker than I would have in reality because I've already solved it a couple times, so I go ahead and give it a shot. So the first thing is I know that I need to return an array, but I know there's always a solution, so I'll just create and return that array when I find the solution. Now the easiest way to look through this array is, let's say the array has five elements in it. Well, what I'll do is I'll just look at all the pairs of elements. So I'll take one counting variable and I'll work my way up from a 0 up to the length of the array minus 1. And then I'll work the second integer up from 1 past whatever my current index is for the first element up to the very end of the array. That will give us all the pairs of items without having to have all the combinations. This will keep me, for example, from testing both index 1 and index 2, and index 2 and index 1. We don't want to test it twice, we only need to see it once. So what we'll do is we'll say for, and I'll use I and j as the counting variables because There's no reason to have them be more complicated names for this. Int I equals 0, I is less than nums.length, I plus plus. Try and follow a good style there. Okay, and then I'll loop from that from right after this index for int j equals 0, j is less than nums.length, and I already saw a problem, j plus plus. So we want to leave space for there to always be one element past the end, so that'll be good. All right, and then we say if nums I plus nums j equals target, then we return new int array with two elements in it, I and j. And the compiler might complain because it doesn't know we're guaranteed to have a solution, so here I'll just say return null if it turns out that there's no solution, which we'll never get to that point. All right, so let's just read over the code real quick, make sure it's okay. I take an integer array that I know is going to be at least two elements and a target value I want to add to. I equals 0, I is less than the length minus 1, I plus plus, j equals 0, j is less than the length, right, because we want it to get to the last item. J plus plus. If you add them together and it's the target, then you know you need to return the value. So that looks right. The next thing I'll do is run code, and usually I don't think I do this time, but usually I have syntax errors that get found by trying to run the code. In this case, it says, hey, look at that, gosh. So it has a single input. I'll go ahead and look at the console, see what my inputs are. Well, it looked right for that. So let's go ahead and use the example test cases. Okay, so here we have three different inputs or four different inputs. And this can also be very illustrative. It's nice they make it so you don't have to actually type those in yourself. Okay, so I will say run code again because I want to see if it'll work with all of my inputs. Wrong answer. Oh, no. Okay, so the output of input. Output. 1, 2, and 0, 1. Okay, so I have a problem. Let's take a look. So we have the input array. Output 0, 1 is fine. The second one, it returned 0, 0. Now why is that? I equals 0, I is less than nums length minus 1, I plus plus, j, oh, there we go. J needs to be I plus 1. So I didn't have a syntax error, but I had an intent error. All right, let's try it again. Okay, well see, there's an error, and that's an embarrassing error to have made, but that is life. So I'll go ahead and submit it and see what it says. It's gonna say it's right, but it's slow. Accepted, uses memory, runs slow. So you can see here, I could work on optimizing it, but for now, I'm going to wrap this up and just call it good. So let me know in the comments if this is useful at all to you, or if you'd like to see more details on the optimal solutions, things like that. I'm happy to go into it with as much or as little depth as people like. Thanks for watching, and keep on pushing forward. Hi, this is John. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please think about subscribing so you get notified of my future videos. Also, if you are interested, you might want to check out the video I have linked here. Thanks, and keep on pushing forward.